What's happening in L.A.?
Visiting family.
On the last season of Praise the Lords, I was making $300,000 a week. 9 years old. What are they offering?
$5 million.
Breathe.
I hired a girl. It's amazing.
Why is it amazing?
This isn't a very glamorous job.
I'm not used to glamour.
She's disfigured, burned in a fire on her face. Do you know how my mother died? In a fire?
No. People don't just enter our lives randomly. We call them.
Welcome to Kermode Uncut. There's a new David Cronenberg film out this week, Maps to the Stars. And I always think of a new David Cronenberg film as being a treat, a case for rejoicing. The new David Cronenberg film, Maps to the Stars, is really, really good. And I'll review it in full on the Radio 5 live show I do with Simon Mayo. But I was casting my mind back over David Cronenberg's back catalogues and trying to choose which of his films were my favourites. I'm a big fan of the early shorts, Stereo and Crimes of the Future. I absolutely loved Videodrome. I even kind of quite liked Existenz, which is sort of a remake of Videodrome. And I was a big fan of The Fly. But of all the Cronenberg films, the one that still stands out for me, the one which is on the cusp between his early body horror works and his later psychological thrillers, is Dead Ringers. Now, I imagine many of you have seen Dead Ringers. In case you haven't, Jeremy Irons plays identical twins, Beverly and Elliot. They are physically exactly the same. One claims to be slightly taller than the other. They're both gynecologists, and they both end up preying in different ways upon a central character played by Genevieve Bujold. The film was made at a time when digital imaging was really a thing of the future. It was done with motion-controlled cameras, and back then it was extraordinary that you could have one actor playing two parts side by side on screen and really not see the join. But what makes Dead Ringers such an extraordinary piece of work is the performance, or more accurately, the performances, which Jeremy Irons gives. As the two central characters, as Beverly and Elliot, he plays two completely different people who look exactly the same, but everything about them says we are different sides of the same coin. It's not the visual trickery that you notice. It's the extraordinary lucidity of Irons' performance. Now, later on, Irons went on to win an Oscar for his role in Reversal of Fortune. And famously, when he was receiving his Oscar, he thanked David Cronenberg, which was very important because it reminded people that actually the person who had really untapped the genius in him was Cronenberg. In the early part of his career, Cronenberg made what were called body horror films. He made things like Rabid and Shivers and The Brood. In the latter part of his career, he aimed more for psychological thrillers. He made an adaptation of Naked Lunch and, of course, Crash. Crash was one of the very first films I gave 5 stars to in a review. It's only a small handful of films I've ever given 5 stars. I think Toy Story and 12 Years a Slave are the only other examples that spring to mind. And, of course, I'm not crazy about star ratings anyway, but Dead Ringers is exactly on the cusp of that change from the early body horror films into the later psychological development films. It's also one of the movies which proved that actually, no matter what people thought of Cronenberg as a visual stylist, his real genius was getting actors to reach areas that they hadn't reached before. You look at later works, things like A History of Violence, with that extraordinary central performance from Viggo Mortensen, and indeed Maps to the Stars, which has a wonderful siren performance by Julianne Moore. What Cronenberg is now famous for is his ability to get the best out of his cast. Go and see Maps to the Stars, and I hope you enjoy it, or maybe that's the wrong word, I hope you get as much out of it as I did. But get Dead Ringers out on DVD or Blu-ray or download it. It's one of those films that reminds you that the key to Cronenberg's work is actually a central humanity. It's to do with people, it's to do with characters, it's to do with things you can believe in, even when they're often surrounded by scrunge and fantasy and craziness. Maps to the Stars is a great movie. Dead Ringers is arguably his best movie.
Amanda, sweetheart, and I hate to be leaving this on your phone, but they announced that Damien went with Azita. I know and I respect the reasons why it was so important to you, but...